Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So today I'm gonna be doing something a little bit different. So I'm gonna be turning this to this. Hey subbies, thank you guys so much for returning, and for those of you watching my videos for the first time, thank you guys so much for tuning in. And if you haven't seen any of my videos before, I have got so many videos that might help you, so don't forget to check it out. And from the intro of this video, I'm sure you already know what we're doing today. Sis, like, we are about to change some game, y'all. So we're gonna be doing something to this very basic afro hair, and we're going to be turning it into some really cool shit. So the first thing you're gonna be doing to your starter kit, dreads or finger curls, is to actually wet the hair. As you can see in this video, I'm going ahead to wet this hair, and I'm being really, really, really furious about it because I really need the water to touch every single strand of the hair. And this step can be skipped if you decide to wash your hair, and that's even better. But my client decided not to wash the hair, and he is punishing me by spraying from this tiny bottle that is taking the whole of my time. Anyway, so get that water in there, sis, and once all of the water is in, the next thing is to bring in oil, because you need your hair protected, especially your scalp. So I'm going to be using the Jamaica Black Castor Oil, and I'm going to start massaging the scalp with the oil. I did a lot of that off camera, and I'm just going to put the rest in there and then massage the oil into the skin. And this is basically very important step because you need the hair hydrated, you need the hair all moisturized before you actually dread it. So you just go ahead and get that oil into your hair to protect the hair from all of the products we're going to be using on the hair. So the next thing is your Kanto leave-in conditioner, but you can use any brand that you want, but I find Kanto very, very helpful in all of my natural hair journey. Kanto has been the get-go, like, it has been my go-to, and I love it. It has a beautiful smell, and it's really, really good for afro hair, especially black hair. The next thing is try to work in that product, like put in effort to make sure that leave-in conditioner touches every strand of the hair. And once the hair is all conditioned properly, I would advise that you don't put too much, because at some point in this video I was struggling to actually finger curl it because the moist was too much, so it was a little bit difficult. So I will say that don't make the mistake that I made, but make sure that you put in enough Kanto, like a right amount of Kanto or a right amount of leave-in conditioner, to help the curls define, or to define the curls properly. So the next thing will be your twist and lock, and you can use gel or whatever. Make sure you use something to hold down that curls, like you need that really defined. So get something, it might be gel, curl activator, twist and lock, dreadlock fix. They've got so many of them in the market. You can just go on Amazon, AliExpress or eBay or whatever, you can get like really cool shit on those sites. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and start, you know, twisting the hair. Now this is a very really tricky part. Like, the back of the hair was so short that I struggled through it, but the reason why I wasn't showing the back of the hair in this video is because I totally forgot right up until the time that I just remembered to show the back of the hair. Like, I didn't even know I was recording the front, so like I was so engrossed in the gist that was going on at the background. Anyway, so I'm just going to go ahead to show you how you finger curl, and this video, most of it will be done off camera. I'll just show you what it's looks like. So just cut a little and then put in your comb and you start twisting. Like I said before, the conditioner was too much, so it was a little bit slippery, but trust me, it helps the curl define better. So you just go ahead and keep twisting it until you feel it's twisted enough and it's twisted to the tip. I struggled through the tip because his hair was a little bit short and my comb was a little bit big. So once you want to use your comb, you should at least try to use a very tiny, weeny, weeny, weeny comb, which I didn't have as of the time I was making this hair. And yeah, basically that's it. You can also use your finger, just like so, just roll it round until you get to the tip. But like I said before, it was a little bit too slippery and I couldn't get my fingers to get it done, so I continue with the comb, and which seems to actually, you know, work a little bit. I don't know, yeah, it did work. So I did a lot of that off camera. And another thing I would like to mention is the fact that this dread or locks, or these locks or these finger curls, can actually pass off as dread in a long term. So this is more like a starter kit for dreadlocks. So if you want to go into dreading your hair, and you know, you can start with this and then lock it every 2 weeks once the root grows. But if you're not into that kind of thing, you can actually do this and then take it out right after 2 weeks. So yeah, that's another piece of information I want to let you guys know. Oh my goodness, guys, like, you can't tell me nothing. You can't tell me nothing. It is looking good, really. Like, I am so impressed with the way it's turning now. And guys, I want to just personally say this channel is not a professional hairstyling channel. This is a DIY channel. I'm learning, we're all learning. I just wanted to carry you guys along my learning journey. So yes, this is my first ever attempt on this finger curls, and trust me guys, I have really tried to do some curls on my short afro hair before when I was growing out my natural hair, and I ended up using that sponge, you know, the one you put in and just rough it all up. But this is on another level, guys. So yeah, basically this is it. This is the hair. So I went ahead and did the last piece of the hair, and as you can see, this is what we're seeing. This is what we're seeing, guys. Like, just wait till I actually dry the hair. So right now it is looking really, really whitish. Like, I have a lot of white residue on the hair, and that is basically because of the leave-in conditioner. So if you've used the leave-in conditioner on your hair before, you would definitely see that it has so much residue right after you've applied it. But until it dries up, is gonna be looking that whitish. So yes, that's what you're seeing right now. So at the end of the day, I finished the hair and it was looking good, looking like this. He was so excited about this hair, actually. So this is basically me going in with the hand dryer and I'm drying all of the hair out, and the aim is to make sure that the white residues disappear once the hair is dried. So that's what I did. And this process was a very long one. It took about 3 hours of time, really, to get this done, and probably because we're going off and on. But yes, we finished up and this is the final result. It looks so good. I was so shocked how it turned out. He's happy, I'm happy, and I hope you guys are happy watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and if you haven't seen any of my videos before, I'm gonna leave links so you can check that out. In the meantime, guys, drink lots of water, moisturize, and I'll definitely be seeing you in another video. Bye.